Everybody, it's Pastor Chris coming to you live. I hope we have worked out kinks from last week, working on different things. I'm set up in a different area of the house so that I have better reception right now. So anyway, good to see everybody out here today. And this is Word of Encouragement on May 4th. And I just want to say to you, May the 4th be with you. I am a big Star Wars fan. I hope you are too. So coming from that Yoda within all of us, I just want to say May the 4th be with you. It is good to be with you here today. We have a great week planned. We're going to be looking at the special women in our lives, our mothers and our wives and our daughters and our grandmothers and our great-grandmothers and all the great women of the Bible. We can't get into it all in one week, but I have a lot of interviews. I've already done some of them. I interviewed my mother, so Cheryl McCombs. She'll be on here probably tomorrow or Thursday. We have the Karenette interview that a lot of us missed. I'll be sharing that on Wednesday. That's already programmed. That will be a premiere showing. And also, I interviewed the women's ministry leaders, a couple of them from our church, Ashley Mabry and Melissa Polonowski. I'll be sharing them in an interview as well. And then I have another interview planned that will be for Friday, and that's going to be interviewing, I've got like 4 or 5 mothers that I'm just going to interview and share that with you. So this whole week is nothing about recognizing the women in our lives as we move towards Mother's Day this Sunday. So I hope that your day is going good for you. I just want to encourage you right now to just anything that you need to pray about, share, or any caring. This is the time to do that. So, Patty, I hear that Dax liked Yoda. So here's what I'm going to do. Dax, if you are out there right now, if you are watching, this is for you. This is just for you, Dax. You ready? May the 4th be with you. So any kids that might be out there watching right now, here's Yoda for you. And again, the 4th of May, may the 4th be with you. Dax, that's just for you. God bless you, buddy. So back with us on the program today. I'm going to read scripture introducing the week. And again, praying, sharing, and caring. I'll get back to the comments later where I can get in there and I can look at those and actually engage you if there are things that are going on. So what I want to do right now is I want to read from Proverbs 31. If you have your Bibles, I'm not going to be pulling up on the screen today, but Proverbs 31. If you have that, we're going to be reading. Again, some people call this the proverbial woman, a woman of wisdom, whatever you want to call it. But this is about ideally what the scripture says. We want the women of our lives to be like. So it says going in verse 10. In 31 chapter of Proverbs, who can find a wife? Noble character. She is far precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her. He will not lack anything good. She rewards him with good, not evil, all the days of her life. She selects wool and flax and works with willing hands. She is like a merchant ships, bringing her food from far away. She rises while it is still night, and provides food for her household and portions for her female servants. She evaluates a field and buys it. She plants a vineyard with her earnings. She draws on her strength and reveals that her arms are strong. She sees that her profits are good, and her lamp never goes out at night. She extends her hands to the spinning staff, and her hands hold the spindle. Her hands reach out to the poor. She extends her hands to the needy. She is not afraid for her household when it snows, for all in her household are double clothed. She makes her own bed coverings. Her clothing is fine linen and purple. Her husband is known at the city gates, where he sits among the elders of the land. She makes and sells linen garments. She delivers belts to the merchants. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she can laugh at the time to come. Her mouth speaks wisdom, and loving instruction is on her tongue. She watches over the activities of her household and is never idle. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Her husband also praises her. Many women have done noble deeds, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord will be praised. Give her the reward of her labor, and let her works praise her at the city gates. May the Lord add a blessing to his holy word. So I want to just say right here, her children rise up, call her blessed, and her husband praises her. What a great thing to have. What we want to see in all the women of our life is that we will be praised, that we will be honored, that we will be blessed. And the women out there watching this week, I just want to encourage you. You're special. Listen, the Lord has uniquely created us, male and female. And I think there's no shame in that. I think masculinity and femininity are good things. And we need to embrace that in a culture that is confused. Which is stop for a minute. The word of encouragement today is to speak truth. Women, we appreciate that you're women. And all the men should say amen, and all the women should say amen. So we want to see women like this proverbial woman, and I hope that the women that are in my ministry, you're encouraged, you're uplifted, you're empowered, and that God wants to use you in a mighty way. And may he. And this whole week, as we talk about motherhood and we talk about womanhood, may we be encouraged. Listen, I am the man I am today because God placed certain women in my life. And tomorrow, most likely, as I air the interview with my mother, she's one of those. Timothy, we know in the scripture that Paul recognized the blessing of Timothy having his mother and his grandmother in his life showing him the way of faith. Thank God for godly women. Thank God for the godly women in our church. Thank God for the women that do all that they do to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. We know Paul had many women around him. Jesus had women in his ministry. I have women in my ministry. So everyone plays a role, and God created us male and female. So I want us to embrace that. That's not something to go against. It's not stereotyping. It's not outdated. Thank God for women. I mean, there's just no other way of saying it. I don't want women trying to be something they're not. I want them to be who God created them to be, and God created us male and female. So masculinity and femininity, I'll do the masculinity talk come Father's Day week. But this week, I want you to know, women, you're so important to the faith. You're so important to each and every one of us. I thank God for my mother, my grandmother, my great-grandmother that I got to know. We'll talk about that a little bit in my interview with my mother tomorrow. But without their influence in my faith, I was a heathen, man. I was worldly. I was ungodly, even having those godly influences in my life. So I just thank God they never gave up on me. I thank God that the women in my life has influenced me. I thank God for my wife that is raising my children in the ways of the Lord. And as they're growing, their faith is theirs now. They found that faith. And listen, I probably played a role in that, but man, my wife played a huge role in that. So I thank God every day for Shawnetta. I thank God for the women in my life that have influenced me. And right now, I want you to write down, go ahead, this is a time to honor. Who are the women that have influenced you in your life that have made you a better person, a better woman, or a better man? Who is that? Go ahead and take the time to write that down in here right now. I'm going to take some time to kind of look and see who people are writing down. So I know there's some prayers that have been shared, but I hope that some of you right now are taking advantage of this opportunity to write down the people you would like to recognize. In fact, I'm going to get in here and I'm going to recognize my mom, Cheryl McCombs. So again, without her, my life would be a lot different. So I'm writing in my mom's name. I encourage you, who is it you need to write in here of people that have blessed you in your life, women that have influenced you. Also just going to write in Shawnetta. So anyway, take the time to remember those people and take the time to recognize them if they're still with you. And this whole week, as we recognize the women in our lives, may you recognize those in your life and in the life of the church. Before we go, there was a presentation last week that fell a little short before I pray with you. I just want to share this short video from Fred Hepler. Here you go. Fred, take it away.
Hey, folks. Fred Hepler here to offer some words of encouragement for my dear church family and share some good news that you can use. As the world is being tested, many are seeing their livelihoods and lifetime ambitions wiped away. Many are looking for answers to the deeper meanings of life. As digital disciples, we have an increased opportunity to be ambassadors of hope during these times of uncertainty. Jesus told us in Matthew chapter 5, verse 16, "In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven." Jesus declared in Matthew chapter 24, verse 14, "And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come." It is so exciting to see Lexington Park Baptist Church embracing technology during lockdown and continue to pursue our mission, be disciples, make disciples. I encourage all of you to pray for our nation's leadership, specifically everyone involved with the Coronavirus Task Force and the upcoming bipartisan council of great doctors and business experts focused on reopening the USA economy. Pray for our president that he will listen for God's whisper for the plan God has for all of us to prosper, to give everyone hope and a future. Please take advantage of all digital disciple opportunities as we continue to sail through choppy waters until we get to calmer seas. Well, folks, that's all I have for now. Be blessed, take good care, and I look forward to seeing you all next time.
Hey, everybody, I'm back with you. Thank you, Fred Hebler, for that awesome message. And I finally got it to you. Again, we're finding out some streaming issues. Praise the Lord. I think we've got this thing worked out. I had to move my studio downstairs, and we've got a jumper that's going to jump the signal back to where I was in the PC studios, and we'll be back there either later this week or next week. So I just want to thank you for being with me today. Again, I have a few things I want to share with you before we close out. I want to pray for you, but once again, I just want to say, this is for Dax. May the 4th be with you. All right, join me in prayer now, and let's pray and ask God to bless us, and then we'll close out. Lord Jesus, we thank you for today. Thank you for the women in our lives. Thank you for all those that posted, all these special women in their lives that have influenced them. We thank you for your scripture. We thank you for the Proverbs chapter 31 that gives us the proverbial woman, that gives us an example of what we're supposed to look for in our mother and what we're supposed to look for in as a husband looking for a wife and what we want to see our daughters grow into. What an admirable text that we can apply. Now we know that all of us fall short, but thank God for the women that strive to be that proverbial woman. I pray for each one in my audience, each one watching this now, live or later on, that you'll bless each woman that seeks to fulfill the calling you have for her life. And we pray that you can make her a blessed woman of God. Pray and thank you for this. And may us men join the efforts to see that women in our lives are held up as a blessing. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, thanks for joining me. I'm glad you were here today. I have a few announcements, and then I'll end this. I pray again we've worked out the kinks. God bless you. Please join us Sundays at 10 a.m. for digital worship at Lexington Park Baptist Church. You can find us at facebook.com/Lexington Park Baptist. Join us weekdays at noon for Word of Encouragement from PC Studios. Pastor Chris McCombs coming live weekdays at noon. We also on Monday evenings, we have digital community groups. Please contact Pastor Joe Fessler for more information. We want to see everyone in a digital group during this time. Also on Wednesdays at 6 p.m., we have WOW, Worship on Wednesdays. We hope you'll join the McCombs family as we bring worship from our home to your home during this time of season. Hey, that's all the information I have for you. This is Pastor Chris signing off. Stay safe, stay strong in the Lord. Until next time, God bless.